Hello everyone, welcome to Programming Knowledge. I hope you are all doing well. Today, we will make my computer as a subscriber and my mobile phone as a publisher. Let's start coding to make my computer as a subscriber. Here, all the things are same as in the previous video, like firstly, I am declaring the connected variable and it's set to false, and also we will declare message received, and also it is set to false. We will see later why I am declaring this variable. After that, we have to declare four more variable, and this variable contains the broker instance information. This information is like broker address, port, user, and password, like in previous lecture. Now, we are going to create a new client instance, and we will pass the argument client identifier. I am passing the MyMQTT string as a client identifier, same as before. To set password and username, we have to call username password set method, and it takes argument like user and password. Here password is optional, but even then I am passing it. Now we have to specify a onConnect callback function, which is called when the broker responds to the connection request. I am just assigning the function for now and define the actual code later. Finally, I am calling the connect method for establishing the connection to the broker. It takes as input the broker address and the port number. As I have told that to process a callback function, we have to call a method called loop start, and this method also run a thread in background to handle the network connection and also sending and receiving data. Now we need to call the subscribe method, and we have to pass the input as a topic as an input. That topic that we want to subscribe to it. In this case, we will subscribe to topic like in the previous lecture, MQTT slash second code. So now any client published to this topic, then that message is also is received by my computer. Since establishing the connection may take a while, so I am writing loop so that loop is executed until previously declared connected variable is set to true. As I said before, the connected variable is set to true in our callback function, which we are going to define later. Now, to get message, we have to wait for some time so that some client publish a message to the subscribe topic. Okay, so I am writing a loop for that also, so that loop is executed until previously declared message received variable, which we have declared previously and we have set to false. Now here we will execute the loop until previously declared message received variable is set to true. In this case, also the message received variable is set to true in callback function. Okay. Now to finish the coding part, we just need to specify the onConnect callback function and onMessage callback function. OnConnect callback function is same as before. Like if RC is equal to 0, then print a success message that client is connected to the broker, and Otherwise, print an error message or client is not connected to the broker. Now, to see that message received by the client, we have to define one more callback function. This callback function is executed when client, that is my computer, receives a message. So here I am just assigning the onMessage callback function, and later we will define the onMessage callback function. Now, let's define this onMessage callback function. It takes argument like client, user data, and message. So define onMessage. If message is received, we know that the message is in UTF-8 string. So first of all, we have to decode it. So we have to decode that message. So how we are accessing the messages? There is a payload member of the class. This payload will be used to get the actual message received from the subscribe topic. So we will print like message received. Now here we are also able to get topic on the which the message is published. Like you have to only write message.topic, just like message.payload. Here you have to write message.topic and you have to print it. Okay, let's run this code. As you see here, client is connected. Now in the app, we have to provide the topic in which we want to publish the message, which and the computer is subscribed to. So here I am typing MQTT/second code. And now here we have to write the message, hi. I am writing hi, and yeah, as you see here, the message is received hi, and the message topic is MQTT/second code. Now again, let's publish message hello from my mobile phone, and let's publish it. Yeah, as you see here, the message received is hello, and the message topic is MQTT/second code. So I hope you're all able to understand the MQTT publish and subscribe coding part. And thank you, guys.